The Department of Infrastructure sought to inform motorists and pedestrians on the proper use of the roundabout. Officials called on them to pay attention to the signs and markings for their safety and that of other road users. It's a single-lane roundabout with two merge lanes, one to head north and the other for eastbound traffic.
We have noticed that persons are using it as if it is a two-lane roundabout in some instances. Persons are not giving way at the roundabout like they were supposed to. So we want to inform the general public that the signs that are posted in the roundabout and the markings are posted, that they are to be used as they are posted, that the bus shelters also, the bus stand or the bus shelters have been relocated, and it's been relocated for the safe use of everyone, that there are pedestrian crossings, that we expect everyone to use the pedestrian crossing when traversing this roadway.
Infrastructure authorities also spoke to parents and children trying to access the Dame Pullet Luizzi School.
This is one of our biggest concerns and one of the reasons that we felt necessary that we inform the general public. There are parents using the intersection to access, to drop or pick up their children from the Dame Pullet. One, the scenario of parents that will be using the bus system. There is an eastbound and a westbound bus which are located after the bridge along the Alan Bousquet Highway. Previously, the bus stand was opposite the Wasco entrance. This, we have deemed, was unsafe to have the children cross two roads to get to school. For example, now that the bus lay-by, what we have done, we have placed the bus lay-by on the exact side of the school. So parents, as soon as their children drop off from the bus, they are able to traverse the pedestrian crossing and enter the school gate safely without having to cross in the morning. In the afternoon, if they're using the bus, again, you have the school warden who can assist them in terms of crossing. They are the pedestrian crossings which have been placed and they are well marked. And we also did a program with the school with the children on how to use the pedestrian crossing, and that we will be continuing that as time goes by with this school.
Questions were also raised on the need for public service announcements, which officials say are currently being put together.
We have been in discussions about a series of public awareness and information campaigns regarding various sections of the roadway and the use of roundabouts in particular. We are in the process of working on that.
The public service announcements will be applicable to all roundabouts. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.